Okay, it's October 12th, 2023, and I'm here getting my makeup done. Or actually, I'm done now. Savannah's inside getting her makeup done, looking absolutely gorgeous. And I'm just so honored to be here to celebrate the joining of Richard and Savannah in holy matrimony. And it's been a long time where we've been thinking about this happening because the engagement happened a long time ago, but I'm just really excited to be here and it's finally here and to support you guys through this. And I just wish you guys the best throughout your marriage. So congratulations and cheers.
Congratulations. I love you guys. I'm so excited to celebrate with you guys today and see what your lifetime brings. I just want to wish you guys the happiest life ever. I'm so glad that we're here celebrating behind you. On your side, we appreciate everything that you do for our family, and we hope we can return the favor, and we love you.
To Savannah and Blanco, I'm so proud of this marriage, and I pray that you have the marriage as long as Papa and I did, and I know it's going to be the only one in forever. I love you both.
Savannah and Richard, congratulations. I hope today is everything you dreamed of. I know you both worked really hard to get here today. I hope that you have an endless supply of happiness, and I'm excited to see where your next chapter goes.
To my beautiful fam, I love you guys. I'm excited for the future for you guys, and I hope throughout this whole experience, it softens your heart and lets you know that you are surrounded with people that love the shit out of you. So I wish you guys the best. Have a great time tonight. Live your best life. And go out there and conquer the world. Love you, my brother, Savannah. we have to fix that. I called her my niece instead of her name. Horrible.
Little hands wrapped around my finger, and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite night light. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. I won't let nobody hurt you. Won't let no one break your heart. No, no one will desert you. Just try to never grow up. And never grow up. In the car on the way to the movies, and you're mortified your mom's dropping you off. At 14, there's just so much you can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too. And don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple.
It takes to come alive.
Love. You say you'll be down in 5. The smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do. I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you. You won't be surprised. It happens every time. It's nothing new. It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you can read my mind. 'Cause when you look at me with those eyes, I'm speechless. Staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. 'Cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room, I'm speechless.
I'm hurting, baby. I'm broken down. I need your loving, loving. I need it now. When I'm without you,
side of the Mississippi River, baby. You're my infinity, no end to you and me. Come hellfire or rain, baby, nothing can change it. No, nothing can change.
Family and friends, I'm going to ask you to please stand. Everybody, you can be seated. Richard, Savannah, I want you to take a moment right now and look at each other. Relax. Let this moment forever be ingrained on your heart. And I want you to take a look at everybody out here real quick. See all these people smiling, waving, right? You know, cheering them on, yes? That's right. This is a beautiful moment. So people have always felt the need to celebrate these really important and beautiful moments in a person's life. So friends and family, Richard and Savannah have invited all of you to be with them in, on this very important day. This day in which they publicly declare their love for each other before all of us. But ultimately, we're here to celebrate with them. We're here to walk with them and to stand with them in the years to come. But why are we here? A friendship, a love that is unique and something that's only shared by both of you. So I just want to share just a few short words. It's only going to take like an hour and then we'll be done. No. Just really short words. that hopefully will encourage you and challenge you both to remember that this is your marriage, this is your relationship. So I want you to look at each other. Remember always the beginning of your love for each other. Now, love is one of the most beautiful experiences that a person can experience in their life. It's a discovery of another life which is as dear as our own. So remember this, that love is more than a feeling or an emotion. It's ultimately this, it's selfless service. It seeks always to create happiness and enjoyment for the other person. So this person that you're holding their hand, this person that you're looking at, this is the person that you get to serve, that you get to love for the rest of your life. Remember this too, that love is patient, even when the results aren't evident. So there will be moments that you won't feel that love, but remember to be patient with each other, to be forgiving with each other, to have grace upon each other. And lastly, I believe if you give everything you can to your marriage, if you give it 100%, not 50-50, because I don't believe there's keeping score in marriage. This is something that you need to give everything you can to. You'll have a beautiful and blessed marriage. So remember to love each other, cherish each other, take care of one another, and remember your friendship that started as the foundation of your love. But here we are to witness your vows, your promises before family and friends. And so Richard, I'm gonna ask you a set of questions, and at the end, if you agree, I'm gonna ask you to please respond by saying I do. All right? Richard, will you take Savannah as the companion of your life and the object of your love and affection? And will you prefer her over all others, standing through sorrow and joy, darkness and sunlight? And will you honor your promises for as long as life and love exist? If you agree, please respond by saying I do. Did you guys hear him?
Nope.
All right, let's.
I do!
All right, there we go. Love it. Now, Savannah, will you take this man, Richard, as the companion of your life and the object of your love and affection? And will you prefer him over all others, standing through sorrow and joy, darkness and sunlight? And will you honor your promises for as long as life and love exist? If you agree, please respond by saying, I do.
I do.
Very good. All heard you. All right. Just joking, just joking. Now, Richard, I'm going to ask you to please repeat the traditional vows after me. Savannah, you're going to do the same, and then you have your own vows that you're going to state to each other, all right? So looking at Savannah, please repeat. I, Richard.
I, Richard.
Choose you, Savannah.
Choose you, Savannah.
From all the world.
From all the world.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Throughout all the changes in life.
Throughout all the changes in life.
I dedicate myself to you alone.
I dedicate myself to you alone.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
In health and in sickness.
Health and in sickness.
For richer or for poor.
For richer and for poor.
To love richer. And protect you.
To love and protect you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Beautiful. Savannah, your turn. Will you please repeat after me? I, Savannah.
I, Savannah.
Choose you, Richard.
Choose you, Richard.
From all the world.
From all the worlds.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Throughout all the changes in life.
Throughout all the changes in life.
I dedicate myself to you alone.
I dedicate myself to you alone.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
In health and in sickness.
In health and in sickness.
For richer or for poor.
For richer and for poor.
To love and protect you.
To love and protect you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Beautiful. Now, Richard and Savannah, you guys have your vows?
Yes.
All right, Richard, we're going to begin with you. If you would please pull them out. And looking at Savannah, go ahead and read them, and I'll hold the mic for you.
All right, sorry, guys. I'm just... All right. Savannah, in my mind, this happened a long time ago. I made the decision to devote the rest of my days growing what we have years ago. The flowers, the drinks, and our favorite people here today are just icing on our gluten-free cake. You tell me that you're not good with words, and you're afraid that you won't be able to get the right message across today, but no words spoken here can ever show me how much you love me more than the way you look at me every day, and the effort that you put in to make sure I'm taken care of. The sparkle in your eyes never fades. Even on the toughest of days, you push through and still try to make sure others are looking after. The strongest person I know, and I have her on my team. I know you were special when you assured me that things would get better after we had to rush out of my smoking 1987 Fleetwood Cadillac that had no business being on the street. You never flinched in the presence of difficulties. You deserve so much and more. For you, I vow to be there to make the hard times easier. I vow to remind you that you were the light in multiple lives. And I vow to continue to build you up if you ever forget that you are my world's greatest wonder. I love you so much.
All right, beautiful. Good job. Excellent. Ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, hold on. I have pockets. Okay.
All right, Savannah, your turn.
Richard, look at us, man. We made it. Today is not the start of you and me. It will just be another one in a million memories we create together throughout our lives. Looking at you right now, I know this is a big moment for the both of us. But with you, everything feels like a big moment. From grocery shopping to our dessert dates, our car rides, singing our favorite songs, I appreciate every single moment with you. It doesn't matter where we are or what we are doing, and it never will, because when I'm with you, I'm happy and I'm home. You are kind, caring, and the most loyal person I know. You never fail to make me smile. I fell in love with you long ago for many reasons, but the main one being the way that you love me. With you, I feel safe, I feel strong, and I feel beautiful. I am so excited to see the world beside you, eating new foods in new places and experiencing new adventures. I'm excited for all the late nights, early mornings, and things we will continue to celebrate together throughout the years. Lost my spot. I vow that in this life, you will never have to go through anything alone. I vow to always kiss you goodbye every morning, even when I'm running late. I vow to be your biggest supporter in life and always lift you up. I want to share a poem that I felt was perfect for this moment. Here goes. And so I will. I do. From every day since we met until the end of time, I choose you, I choose me, and above all else, I choose us. So today, in front of our friends and family, we make official what I have always known. You are my forever. I love you so much.
Beautiful. Now for the rings, please. I'm going to go ahead and take them out of the box, and if you would please hold each other's ring just for a moment. So I want you to take a moment to examine each other's rings. These are a beautiful symbol of your love. Now, throughout time, the ring has always carried a very special significance. So rings at one time carried a family seal, which was used to guarantee the integrity of a document, to prove that the bearer stood behind their word. So let these rings be a reminder of your love for each other and that you stand behind your vows, your word today. So Richard, I'm going to ask you to place the ring on Savannah's finger. And as a symbol of your love and promise towards her, please repeat these ring vows after me. Today I give you.
Today I give you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will ever become.
And all that I'll ever become.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my soul.
And my soul.
Savannah, take this ring.
Savannah, take this ring.
And be my wife.
And be my wife.
Because with you.
Because with you.
I am complete.
I am complete.
Beautiful.
I promise it does.
There you go. And Savannah, I'm going to ask you to place the ring now on Richard's finger, and looking at him, will you please repeat these same ring vows after me? Today I give you.
Today I give you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will ever become.
And all that I will ever become.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
My heart.
My heart.
And my soul.
And my soul.
Richard, take this ring.
Richard, take this ring.
And be my husband.
And be my husband.
Because with you.
Because with you.
I am complete.
I am complete.
Beautiful. I want you to hold hands for this last moment. Now, as you hold hands, remember this. The hands that you're holding are the hands that you get to hold. The person that you get to serve. The person that you get to love. Your companion through life. So give everything, like I said earlier, 100%, and you'll have a beautiful and a blessed marriage. God bless you both. And now, by the authority given to me by the state of California, I have the honor and the privilege of declaring you husband and wife. Richard, you may kiss your lovely bride. You want to face your family and friends? And if we can get our bouquet back. Okay. You want to do that? All right. You guys can take out your pictures now, the groom said. Your pictures, your phones out. And then, if you'd like, but here's the thing, we're going to cheer, we're going to scream really loud for the new Mr. and Mrs. Richard and Savannah Blanco. Now, phones away.
Shall I try to get it down? Boy, you fill my head with pieces of a song I can't get out. Can I be close to you? Ooh, ooh. Can I be close to you? Can I take it to a moment where the fields are painted gold and the trees are filled with memories of the feelings never told? When the evening pulls the sun down and the day is almost through, the whole world is sleeping, but my world is here. Can I be close to you? Ooh, ooh. Can I be close to you?
The dawn is breaking, a light shining through. You're barely waking, and I'm tangled up in you. Yeah. Da-da.
And Savannah Blanco! Yeah, that's right. Make some noise one more time for Mr. and Mrs. Richard and Savannah Blanco. Well, I'm gonna hand the microphone over to them. They're gonna say a few words to all of you. So everyone, direct your attention over to the dance floor, our newlyweds.
Hello, hello, everybody. Sorry, I'm kind of nervous still. So, you know, public speaking is not my best thing, but hey, we'll get through this, right? I just want to take this time out to really thank you guys, right? This is our thank you for you guys to take time out of your very, very, very busy schedule to get here. I know it's a little ways, but hey, you love us enough and we love y'all, right? That's it. Hey, so I just want to point out that everybody here has, at some point or another, has had a big impact on me, our Savannah, in one way or another, and we love all of you guys so much. Okay? I heard. There you go. Hey, all right, turn up on a Thursday. I just want to point out that we heard one time that we would never, somebody told us one time we would never get this group ever again, like together, right? So these are different people from different walks of life, different sides of the family. We'll never see this family here or this people, group of people here together ever again, and we appreciate the hell out of you guys. So we want to make sure that you guys just sit here and enjoy the rest of the night, party up with us. Because it's been a long time coming. I love this girl so much, and I want y'all to be here to witness that. So, thank you guys.
This one's for you. Baby, you my everything. You all I ever wanted. We could do it real big, bigger than you ever done it. You be up on everything. Another whole thing, never own it. I want this forever. I swear I could spend whatever on it. Cause she hold me down every time I hit up. When I get right, I promise that we gon' live it up. She made me beg for it till she give it up. And I say the same thing every single time. I say, you the you the best. 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 Best I ever had. I say, you know you got a roommate. Call me when there's no one there. Put the key under the mat and you know I'll be over there. I'll be over there. Shout it, I'll be over there. I'll be hitting all the spots that you ain't even know is there. And you don't even had to ask twice.
I don't say what's on my mind quite as much as you'd like me to. I've been hearing that my whole life, I promise it's not just you. But I so confidently want you that when you say you're insecure about my feelings, I don't take you serious. But if you need me to tell you more, you're one of the few things that I'm sure of. You're one of the few things that I know already I could build my world of. One of the few things that I'm sure of. And I want you to unravel me. Come closer, come closer. Come closer, come closer. I don't say what's on my mind quite as much as you like me to. Yeah, and often when I'm quiet you worry I'm hiding from you. And I know I keep a lie to myself, but still you're more part of me than anybody else. So if you tell you more. You're one of the few things that I'm sure of. You're one of the few things that I know already I could build my world of. One of the few things that I'm sure of. And I want you to unravel me. Come closer, come closer.
What a beautiful first dance. Let's clap it up for Savannah and Richard. Great job, great job. Well, that was their first dance. Savannah, don't go anywhere just yet, because right now I'd like to welcome up David, her father, for the father and daughter dance. Let's go, David. You're looking good, David. All right, this is your dance with your daughter.
Yeah. as I let you go. Gonna tell you how much I love you, though you think you already know. I remember I thought you looked like an angel wrapped in pink, so soft and warm. You've had me wrapped around your finger since the day you were born. From the outside in, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this old world, but to me you know you'll always be. That crooked little smile melted my heart of stone. Now look at you, I've turned around and you've almost.
What an amazing dance. Thanks so much for coming up here, David. Beautiful dance. Thank you, David. And now, Savannah would like to dance with her mom as well. Let's welcome to the dance floor, Maria. This is your song. And this is a surprise. She didn't know this was coming. So this is your moment. Hope you enjoy this dance with your daughter.
Mama, you taught me to do the right things. So now you have to let your baby fly. Thing called life, and I know you watched me grow up and only want what's best for me, and I think I found the answer to your prayers, and he is good, so good. He treats your little girl.
Savannah and her mom, what a beautiful surprise. Thanks for coming up here, Maria, and dance with your daughter. Aww. One more time, let's clap it up for both parents, David and Maria. Well, speaking about some special dances, we have a special dance right now that's going to involve all of you. But right now, we're going to kick off. Savannah, Richard, let's have you in the middle of the dance floor. I'll be playing a slow song. And I want you to listen. I have some very careful instructions as we go along. Right now, as you can see, we're starting off with Savannah and Richard. This is their moment right here. And you also get a moment.
Somewhere, oh.
dream really do come true. Someday you wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow.
First time doing this, so bear with me, please. Alrighty. First of all, thank you for making best man. I appreciate it. Good evening, everyone. I'm Robert, the younger brother of Richard. I have the honor of being the best man tonight. We're all here to celebrate the love between my brother and Savannah, and I want to thank all of you for being here today. Thank you. What could I say about my brother? Well, he's always been my role model. Let's see if we can get it out. So we didn't always have the easiest life growing up. But it's like jumping off the cliff, you know what I mean? We didn't always have the easiest life growing up, but he used that to become the best version of himself. I know that whenever I need him, he's always going to be there. It can be middle of the day or 3 o'clock in the morning in the work night. He might not always show it, but when he loves you, you just know it. My brother and I grew up in different homes with opposite grandmas, but I feel like that just made our relationship much stronger. We always looked forward to spending time together. It wasn't until high school that we actually lived in the same household. Growing up together, we laughed, we joked around a lot, but after living together, I was able to see a different side of him, a more responsible side. He always looked out for me. For example, he was like my alarm clock. No matter how much he annoyed me, no matter how much time I told him, just leave me alone. I don't want to go to school. He said, no, get up. We got to get you to school. Go to your classes. Just get there in time. He'd also share food with me at times, and it's kind of funny. It brings me to a funny story, I have to say. You know, our memories, you know, they're filled with moments of brotherly love and, of course, the occasional rivalry. I remember a time we were super hungry. We called my mom for a pizza. When the pizza finally arrived, I ate my slices, and then I started reaching for some of his. He wasn't having it. I was pretty petty, and I just tossed the rest on the floor. If I couldn't have it, nobody could. Not one of my best moments, but I think we can look back now and we laugh about this now. It's a pretty funny story. Savannah, I remember meeting her in high school, probably volleyball. She was a little younger than we were, so our paths didn't cross much, but over the years, I've gotten to know her better, and after knowing her for so long, I've seen her change my brother in a good way. I can see how much he means to her and how much she means to him. Sorry, guys. Give me 1 second. How much you mean to him. Savannah, you've always been wonderful to my niece, and that shows the type of person you are. Loving, generous, and helpful. You didn't have to look out for her, but you took it upon yourself to make Layla feel so loved and included. So thank you. And whatever the future holds for you and my brother, you guys tackle it together, and I know you'll get through it. Now I'd like to share a story about the couple. It's a story of the proposal. Savannah's happy place is in the mountains, so it makes sense that my brother proposed to her up in the mountains. We went to Lake Arrowhead, where he planned for close friends and family to be. I could see how nervous he was as he took that knee, but once she said yes, their faces lit up with pure joy, and it's a sight I'll always remember. Over the years, it's been a joy to watch your journey from high school sweethearts to now husband and wife. My advice to you is to communicate, be patient, and love each other. Life will present challenges, but your bond can overcome anything. So now,
this is the cheer part.
So now let's raise our glasses to Richard and Savannah. May your love story continue to inspire us all. May you always find joy, laughter, and love in each other's company. I wish you guys nothing but happiness. Savannah, welcome to the Blanco family. I love you both. Cheers.
What an amazing job. That was the best, man. Let's clap it up for Robert Blanco. Thanks for coming up here. Good job for your first time, Robert. Well, cool. Well, that was our first speech, and we really enjoy the support, you know, as everyone comes up here. That was the best, man. And now it is time for our next speech. Everyone, let's focus and give me a warm welcome to this person, our maid of honor, Jessica Flores.
Well, good evening, everyone. I want to start by thanking my beautiful sister and my handsome brother-in-law for allowing me to be a part of their special day. I'd like to just take a moment and say how absolutely phenomenal you both look. And I mean, this venue is absolutely stunning. The toppers for our cute little drinks, the flowers, everything is just absolutely perfect. The grand entrance, though, guys, like, how good was that? Can I get a round of applause for the bridal party? That was, like, so much fun. Okay, so I hope the two of you are in awe as all of us here. I'm going to try to keep this simple and sweet with one objective, to cry fewer tears than my mom. Because we know she's, like, the biggest crybaby. All right. So, many of you know me, but for those who don't, I'm Jessica, maid of honor and proud sister of the bride. Savannah is everything one could ask for in a sister. She's caring, crafty, empathetic, and brutally honest at times. And she may have not gotten the OCD clean freak, like all of us girls, like from my mom, but I did call you out, I'm sorry. But I will say, Richard here handles that perfectly. You know, I am going to say you do what you can, you know, and either way, you're going to make a perfect wife. Sorry, girlfriend. Most of you know our lovely couple met in high school. Volleyball is what I would say sparked the flame and brought us all here today. That's why we're all here, right? I remember Savannah would take my son, Jaden, to practices and games. And I was like, cool, like, me time. I'm getting time away from my son. Little did I know that she was going because she had her eyes on someone. All right, so that is when Mr. Richard here came into our lives. He was definitely quiet, the quiet one. And if you know our family, which, if you guys don't tonight, you guys will see everyone here. And we are not a quiet group at all. We can be a lot much. Obviously, table one is being much. They need to kind of chill. It didn't take a lot of time before Richard to come out of his shell, and he just fit right in with us. I soon came to realize that this person truly cared about my baby sister. Not only did he care about her, he also loved her. From the way he looks at her to the way he always tries to make sure she's okay. There's no mistaking his love for her. I'm so happy that she found her person who cares for her so much. All right. I'm trying not to cry, guys. I've been trying this all day. I know that Richard will continue to keep her happy and she will keep him happy as well. Richard, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you a part of our lives. You are truly a perfect partner for my sister. Thank you for loving her the way she deserves, for always sticking by her side. I truly appreciate you. Okay, all right, if everyone can please raise your glasses with me to the new Mr. and Miss Blanco, and just all Mr. and Mrs. Blanco. All right, and always remember, the best thing to hold onto in life is to each other. I love you guys. Cheers.
Thank you so much for coming up here. That was our maid of honor, Jessica Flores. Clap it up for Jessica right now. And thank you for sharing that piece of wisdom towards the end. So we heard from Robert, we heard from Jessica, and now up here, I'd like to welcome our groomsman, Anthony Wade. How are you feeling, Anthony? You're feeling good? He is ready. He's ready. All right.
All right, how's it going, guys? What up, what up, what up? I didn't know I was this early, but I'm here. So congratulations, I'm here. So my name is Anthony. A lot of you guys know me as Wade. Blanco and Scarlett both call me Wade. Met Blanco in high school. Was always a rough time at first, you know? We weren't always the best of friends at first and whatever. And, you know, I noticed he had a different personality than I would have expected, and I was welcome to at first. I was like, what the heck, who's this guy? But over the years, you know, he started coming around a little bit more often, and, you know, we noticed that we had a little bit more in common than we thought, you know? We'd go play volleyball together and whatnot and do some stuff, and that's kind of how volleyball kind of puts us all together at the end of the day. And more we'd hang out, you know? And more I saw a little different side of him, and that was what blew my mind, you know? I'm not real good person at like first time, like, you know, I see you here and that's what I take you as. It took a second for him to kind of grow on me. And then eventually I was like, oh, I see what you're about, you know? So we would take trips to Orange County every other week to go play volleyball, chase our dream essentially, you know what I mean? And we had long conversations every single time. Me, him, our other friend Kevin, and we'd speak and we'd ask questions. He would always ask questions like, hey, if you have a kid, what's her name? You know, if you could name your car, what would your car's name be? What's your dream car? You know, I'm like, what the heck's going on? What are you asking me? You know, cause I'm just not that type of person. And he would ask these questions and I never really understood many of them. And then I realized all those things matter. You know, a lot of those things were super important to him, you know? He held on to a lot of those things, and those are core values he saw in like someone and his friends and the people he wanted around him. And then eventually, in comes Savannah, AKA Scarlett. And I was like, okay, cool. And then I realized, I said, oh, you must like her, dude. Like, what the heck? Because people around him, he's, you know what I mean? You're not just around him because, like, he likes you. He wants you there for sure, you know, and he appreciates you, and he shows you that he appreciates you. And then I realized, like, oh, this guy loves the people around him, and he will let you know every step of the way, you know, and he will make sure, like, hey, I need you here, and I want you around me, and I appreciate you. He will tell you that 20 times out of the time, you know, and he's always made me feel appreciated, and he's always made me feel welcomed, and that just pushes me even further to kind of reciprocate the you know, the love, you know? Whether it's, hey, hey, can you pick me up from here or whatever? And now it's the other way around where he's like, hey, Anthony, can you give me this? Or, hey, Wade, do this, you know? So it's all love. And that's love for both of them. They've been around for my kid's birth and the rest of it other than that. So we appreciate them, and they know that we got their back like they've always had us. And cheers to the newlyweds, and we wish them the best of luck and everything like that, and we will always be with them every step of the way. Cheers.
That was Anthony Way. Let's clap it up for our groomsmen. Amazing speech. Thanks for coming up here. And last but not least, I'd like to welcome up here our groomsman, Kevin Poku.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kevin, as just previously announced, and I would like to say forgive me if I ramble or lose my train of thought. So I met Richard Blanco when I was about 16. So it's a little over 14 years ago playing volleyball. And when I had to make this speech, I had to kind of figure out like what drew me to Richard. And the qualities that I remember was passion, dedication, and confidence. Just a little touch. Obviously, volleyball, you figured out, it's been mentioned a lot. That's what drawed us all together. There's been a lot of good volleyball players that has come through our school. He's one of the great ones. And I'm not just saying that because he's you know, the groom. If there's a Mount Rushmore, this man's on it. Through our years of playing, and like Wade said, we've gone out and we spent a lot of time together. A lot of time traveling out to different cities, playing the game we love. And one thing that I learned from those experiences is that how selfless he is. Everything that he had, he shared with us. I remember Calvin, the Jeep he had, he would give me rides home. He would travel out to play games. I remember the Cadillac too. If you guys don't remember the vows, he mentioned the Cadillac. I remember $5 pizzas. We would scrounge together, get $5. We get the $5 Little Caesar pizzas and 69-cent Circle K drinks. We would head to his house on Nona and we'd watch movies. That's kind of our friendship. His brother mentioned that he didn't have much, but whatever he had, he's willing to share with us. At one point in time, Blanco lost everything. And through, no one was able to help him, not because we didn't, but because we couldn't. I saw him have nothing, and I've never told you this, but I've told this story to many people to describe his character. He had absolutely nothing, but he pulled himself up by his bootstraps, and he got it out the mud. Woo! I'm so proud of you for that. For me, with my worldview of the world, I think that a man is judged on his ability to provide. I truly believe that if you have nothing, I don't know if this is correct, but it kind of lessens your value to other people. But if there's one thing that if I think back on that moment, Scarlett was always there. During the vows, he said how when the Cadillac, you know, burst up in smoke, she told him that everything was gonna be okay. She never left his side. I remember him telling these stories about her bringing him food and sandwiches and being there for him. I mean, it doesn't mean anything much coming from me, but I'd say thank you, because you were just there for him. You didn't care what he had. You believed in him and valued him. And it paid off, right? Look, we're here today, and this is what they've accomplished. If I think about two moments, about the reasons why I love this man as a brother, I think about how he didn't have much, as I've already mentioned, and how whatever he had, he shared with me. But the second thing I would like to say is that we have very strong personalities. I have a personality that's not easy to get along with. If there's a hill that I believe on, I'll die on it. I'll die on it. And I remember that we got into this huge fight. Wade was there. It was a fight to where he said, I can't be friends with this man. He's unbearable. We had it out. Absolutely. Like, that was the end of the friendship. Also, at that time, I was going through a difficult heartbreak. We all had, like, a first love, and it didn't last. I'm not sure the amount of time that elapsed, maybe one day or two, but by chance or fate, we all three ended up in the same building. And I couldn't handle it. I went right to him and said, hey, I need you. And he was there for me. Didn't matter how deep the fight that we had, he was there for me. That's what friends are for. During that time, during that breakup, I was at this man's house every day from sun up to sundown, eating his food, watching his Netflix. I'm telling you, I was annoying. And that's who he is, using a shower, everything, getting car rides. And throughout the whole time, I would like to thank Savannah because she was unbothered. She was there, she understood what I was going through, and she was there for me too. I can't tell you how, if you go on her laptop, there's probably countless documents about my college assignments on there because she would let me use her laptop. It's still there. This is who they are. They both have been there for me no matter what. And what I would like to end off on, which is how I know that he loves you, is that 4 years ago when Lonnie came into my life, we sat at the Jack in the Box. You had both gone and we had sat there for 4 hours. And he told me all the ways of how you're there for him, how you make him feel, how you love and support him and cherish him. And we're here today, but I knew long ago that you guys were going to marry each other and how much you mean to him. He loves you. I know you know it, but I'm telling you, even when you're there, he's speaking about you behind your back, that he loves you to the moon and back. I wish you well wishes, but you guys don't need it. You guys have been, in my mind, and I'm sure in his, you've been married for the last 10 years. So I'd like to raise your glass one final time to now the official Mr. and Mrs. Blanco.
Kevin Vogel.
Well, there's a party going on. lechona. Todos la conocen con el apodo lechona. Su marido dice ya no sé qué hacer con ella. Diario va a los bailes y se compra una botella. Diario va a los bailes y se compra una botella. Se arranca la banda con la primera canción. Y la chona luego, luego busca bailador.
Oro soy yo. Oro who. Oro soy yo.
Y en inglés.
Salento.
Y otra vez.
Salento.
Ah, pues dale mambo. Apretadito, apretadito ahí. Presidente del merengue, mami. Yesa, sa, sa. Pero bueno, vamos a hacer el baile del piper que dice. Ok. El baile del piper se baila de esa manera ahí. Suavecito, 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 suavecito. Más rapidito ahora. Rapidito, rapidito, tembladito, tembladito, como el viper, como el viper.
El baile del viper, 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 el baile del viper,
la vipió,
el baile del viper,
la vipió,
el baile del viper,
la vipió,
el baile del viper,
la vipió, al mambo, al mambo, al mambo. Y si tú la vipeas y no te devuelve la llamada. La soltera, la soltera, la soltera.
Yeah!
bésame, bésame
suave,
bésame otra vez
suave,
yo quiero sentir tus labios
suave,
besándome otra vez
suave,
besa, besa
suave,
bésame un poquito
suave,
besa, 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 besa
suave,
bésame otro ratito
suave.
Pequeña, échate pa' acá. Cuando tú me besas, me siento en el aire. Por eso cuando te veo, comienzo a besarte. Y si te despegas, yo me despierto de ese rico sueño que me dan tus besos suavemente.
Bésame, que yo quiero sentir tus labios
besándome otra vez suavemente. Ese coro.
Bésame,
es la cosa.
Yo quiero sentir tus labios
besándome otra vez. Bésame suavecito, sin prisa y con calma. Dame un beso bien profundo.
Alright, so this is mainly just for advice that we give. We're giving each other from the past in those times of need, those times that things are a little shaky. Hopefully they're not, but if they are and things happen, just remember how you felt today and how you felt honestly every day for the past 10, 11 years, right? If you feel like you feel differently about her or me in this case,
yeah,
you have to talk. You have to talk to the other one, because I'm sure that it'll be felt through the relationships if something changes, if we're not really showing as much affection and so on. The other one misses you, okay? The other one is sitting at home thinking, why isn't it the same? And it's up to you to make it back to what we are today, okay? So I want you to just think about that. The other one loves you so much.
Yes.
Really?
I do. No, I love you. I don't get a word.
Come on, give me something. Give me something.
I have nothing.
She has nothing. Take what I said.
His advice is perfect.